Bobby, it seems like even after the elections, the weird stories continue. How about the Food and Drug Administration story where they find melamine in baby formula that's sold in the United States? It put thousands, tens of thousands of infants in a hospital in China, and now they're finding it in formulas in the U.S. Now, the interesting thing is, anytime you hear these words, I know the answer to this, because we've talked about it so many times. But anytime you hear the FDA say, we don't think there's a problem here, we know that trace levels don't pose any kind of risk, what's the first thing that comes to your mind?
I want to take these FDA guys home and just feed them this stuff by the barrel that they approve. I mean, the whole thing is that the agency is just a joke.
Yeah. Well, here's something that causes renal...
Trace levels are no problem. Trace levels, no. It's melanine, melamine, which, of course, destroys kidneys. It can kill you. It destroys renal function. And here's a list of the places it's been found just for our listeners. Good Start Supreme infant formula with iron made by Nestle. There's another substance that's related called cyanuric acid, and it also was an Enfamil Lipil with iron. That's an infant formula made by Mead Johnson. But this is the same thing that 50,000 Asian infants were hospitalized, as you say, and four died.
Yeah. Interesting thing is, one breath, the FDA says, no, there is... We don't know what the safe levels are. We don't know whether trace levels pose a risk whatsoever. They say that day one, and then after they're caught, the thing they say is, everything's going to be okay here. First day is they don't know what the effects are. They have no idea. As a matter of fact, just a month ago, the FDA had been very clear that they couldn't set safe levels for melamine in baby formula. And today they said, oh, no problem. It's just a classic FDA story. What story do you have?
Let's do two more about toxics in the environment.
Okay.
One is, White House, as you know, is rushing to promulgate all these midnight regulations that will enrich industry by poisoning the American public. And one of the more recent additions to this list is an attempt to ease the standards on lead emissions. We banned leaded gasoline back in the 70s, and after that ban, the IQ level of American children measurably increased directly as a result of the ban of leaded gasoline, which, of course, all the industry said that this was going to be a catastrophe for our country.
In spite of Britney Spears and Lindsay Lohan, it did. It actually got better, didn't it?
Exactly. And we have, with those exceptions, and we have, but there was still large amounts of lead being added to our air by cement plants, by smelters, as you and I know, because we won a $500 million case against a smelter last year, steel mills and other factories that emit about 1,300 tons of lead into the air each year. Even a molecule of lead can decrease IQ in children who inhale it and get it into their lungs. So the EPA has promulgated standards, stringent standards, to monitor near factories that emit lead, and the Bush administration had quietly weakened a key provision exempting dozens of industries from that kind of scrutiny. The other similar related story is that the Labor Department is racing to complete a new rule that that is strenuously opposed by President-elect Obama that would make it much harder for the government to regulate toxic substances and hazardous chemicals to which workers are exposed on the job. This affects millions of workers around the country. And it's the Bush administration is trying to, at the Chamber of Commerce and the Bush administration, and these big polluters are trying to continue to poison their own workers and get rid of the rule that would require them to monitor it.
You know, Bobby, you know what the backstory is on this? We remember the 2001 energy hearings and energy meetings that Cheney had behind closed doors, secret kind of deal with Exxon, Enron, all the polluters. Well, what people missed, they focused on that just being an energy story. It wasn't just an energy story. It was the fact the U.S. Chamber of Commerce was there, Dow Chemical was there, International Paper was there. This was a giveaway, a payback to all of these corporations that put hundreds of millions of dollars on the George Bush ticket. Okay, so now
the energy industry put $156 million into that 2000 election cycle. So
yeah, but now think about this.
This was a payback where they won, and they, you know, they literally used words like, you know, it's time to divide the plunder.
Yeah. Well, okay, but that's why we're seeing all this 11th hour stuff. That's why you're seeing the workers that no longer have safety of knowing that the toxins they're working around won't kill them. That's why you have why we're mining uranium in the Grand Canyon, 5 miles away from the Grand Canyon National Park. That's why we have the new energy industries that are able to ignore controls over greenhouse gases. That's why you have the pig farmers that can put waste into the waterways without it being these are all new executive orders, understand. That's why the lumber industry and the mining industry can rape and plunder without any oversight, because these new 11th hour executive orders being pushed through by Bush are all about paybacks.